Dear students, as we talked about that Lankos, whose crop was completely destroyed, he wanted help from God and he wrote a letter to God, and for that letter he went to town, placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. And one of the employees who was a postman and also helped at the post office went to his boss laughing heartily. Means when Lankos went there to the post office to submit his letter, he put the letter inside and he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped the letter into the mailbox. One of the employees who was a postman and also helped at the post office went to his boss laughing heartily and showed him the letter to God, because they were very surprised to see Lankos' letter, because never in his career as a postman had he known that address, because generally we do not write any letter to God. So in the postman's career he had never known that address to God. The postmaster. Now here the author shows the appearance of the postmaster. The postmaster, who was a fat, amiable fellow. Amiable means loving fellow, also broke out laughing. Means when he saw the address there on the letter, he started laughing. But at the same time, he turned serious and tapping the letter on his desk, commented. Tapping means he threw the letter on the desk and he commented there, "What faith! I wish I had the faith of the man who wrote this letter." Means now the postmaster got very surprised to see that letter, and he said there how much faith Lankos had in his God, and he wanted the same faith. Starting up a correspondence with God means he started talking directly to God. So in order not to shake the writer's faith in God, the postmaster came up with an idea. Because the postmaster was a kind-hearted person, so he did not want to shake Lankos' faith in God. So he came up with an idea. He decided to answer the letter. But when he opened the letter, it was evident that evident here means clear. It was clear that to answer the letter, he needed something more than goodwill, ink and paper. So for example, the postmaster decided to write something in the letter. Means the letter did not only want the goodwill, ink to write and paper to write. He wanted something else, because we all know that Lankos needed 100 pesos for his help and to survive. But he stuck to his resolution, means he was confirmed to help Lankos. So he asked for money from his employees. As I told you before that the postmaster was a kind-hearted person, so he decided to help Lankos. And he started collecting money from his employees. He himself gave a part of his salary. And several friends of his were also obliged to give something for an act of charity. Because Lankos needed money. Okay. Because he had mentioned there in his letter that his crop was completely destroyed. So the postmaster, who was a kind-hearted person, he decided to give a part of his salary. And several friends of the postmaster, they were also very happy to give something for this act of charity. It was impossible for him to gather the 100 pesos. means now the postmaster and the other employees were not able to collect the complete money which Lancho had demanded in his letter. And what was the money, students? 100 pesos. So he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half. Means now the postmaster was able to collect only 70 rupees. So after collecting 70 rupees, he put the money in an envelope addressed to Lancho and with it a letter containing only a single word as a signature. And what the postmaster wrote there, students? They wrote there good. Okay, means first of all, the postmaster collected money. He himself gave a part of his salary and other employees also collected some money, but they were not able to collect 100 pesos. They were able to collect only a little more than half. In short, we can say that they collected 70 rupees, 70 pesos. They put that money in an envelope and at what the address was written there? They wrote to Lancho and with the letter he also made a signature there. He wrote the signature of God. Now move towards the third check. The following Sunday, Lancho came a bit earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter for him. Means the following Sunday, the coming Sunday, Lancho decided to go to post office because he was eager to get some money. He was very excited to know that if there was a letter for him or not. It was the postman himself who handed the letter to him. While the postmaster, experiencing the contentment of man who has performed a good deed, looked on from his office. After reaching there, means what? Was there the Lancho himself handed the letter to him, and while the postmaster experiencing the contentment of a man, contentment means satisfaction, because the postmaster was satisfied to give him some money. Okay, so he was satisfied that he has performed a good deed. Good deed means good action. Looked on from his office, Lancho showed not the slightest surprise on seeing the money, because Lancho was confirmed that he would receive some money very soon. So he was confirmed. So Lancho showed not the slightest. Slightest means a little bit. It's little bit. He was not surprised on seeing the money. Such was his confidence. Such was his confidence means he was very confident that he would receive some money very soon. But he became angry when he counted the money. As I told you before, because the postmaster and the other employees were not able to collect 100 pesos, they collected only 70 pesos. So Lancho got angry when he counted the money, and he started thinking that God could not have made a mistake, nor could he have denied Lancho what he had requested. Means ki God to mistake nahi kar sakte, and nor could he have denied Lancho's, aur na hi wo Lancho ko mana kar sakte hain, deny kar sakte hain what he had requested for. Immediately Lancho went up to the window. Window means mail window, to ask for paper and ink. On the public writing table, public writing means where all the persons write. Okay, so on the public writing table, he started to write with much wrinkling of his brow. Means he was very confused. Hum jab brow, eyebrow. Okay, means with the wrinkle of his brow caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. Means he was very confused when he started writing, but he had to express his ideas there. And when he finished, means what he was doing there, by this action it clearly shows that Lancho was writing a letter to God. And when he finished, means when he completed his writing, he went to the window to buy a stamp once again, which he licked with his mouth and then affixed to the envelope. Means now what he had done when he completed the letter, he licked the stamp and he fixed the stamp on the envelope with a blow of his fist. Fist means mutti. Okay, with a stroke of his fist, he fixed the stamp there on the envelope. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster, he hurried towards the letter to open it. जैसे ही लेंचो ने क्या किया, लेंचो ने लेटर अपना मेल बॉक्स में डाला, द पोस्ट मास्टर वेंट टू ओपन इट. इट सेड, एंड व्हाट वाज द रिटन इन द लेटर, गोड ऑफ द मनी दैट आई आस्क्ड फॉर ओनली 70 पैसोज रीच्ड मी, बिकॉज लेंचो हैड डिमांडेड 100 pesos and he had mentioned in the second letter that he asked for 100 pesos but only 70 pesos reached to him. Send me the rest. Rest means the rest of the money since I need it very much. These are the wording of the second letter. Okay, so what he wrote there, of the money that I asked for, how much money he had received, only 70 pesos, and send me the rest of the money because Lencho said that he needed the money very much. But remember God, do not send it to me through the mail. Means do not send the letter to me through the mail because the post office employees. Yes, students, listen to this line carefully. Because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks. Lencho. Crooks here means the cheaters. Because Lencho was quite confident that God would send him the money. Okay. And he complained there in the second letter that his 70 pesos were reached to him. Okay. And he thought that the post office employees, they are a bunch of cheaters. So they had stolen some part of his money. Okay, finally we can see here that how Lencho wrote a letter to God. Means he was quite confident that when his crop is completely destroyed, he would get some money. Okay, and he was very certain that God would send him the money. Okay, and in this situation, in the very last of this, here the ironical situation is created. Ironical means in spite of being praised, praised by Lencho's, the post office employees are called here a bunch of cheaters. Matlab unki praise karni chahiye thi Lencho ko for sending some money. Okay, but here ironic situation is created because it is the opposite of what is expected, because the postmaster and the other employees were expecting that they would be praised. Okay, but Lencho, he said to them a bunch of cheaters. This is it with this chapter. Read the chapter carefully and try to solve the questions of part 2nd and 3rd. Thank you.